It is no secret, my friends, that Call of Duty is a game that is dominated by SMGs. It's been that way ever since Call of Duty 4, and it probably isn't going to change anytime soon. But what SMGs get the job done better than any others? What SMGs get the job done quicker? What is up, everybody? Chaos here. Welcome to the COD History Series. Today, we're going to be checking out my personal list for the 10 fastest killing SMGs in COD history. You guys let me know, what is your favorite SMG of all time in the Call of Duty franchise? Drop a like and let's jump into it. At number 10, I'm going to go with the VMP in Black Ops 3. Kicking off our list is one of the most used weapons in BO3 that some people would even call overpowered for a while. Now, the VMP is one of the first weapons that you unlock in Black Ops 3, which is very vital here, okay? And it's pretty much undoubtedly the best all-around SMG in the game. By default, the VMP has a 40-round mag and will deal up to 30 damage per bullet while firing at 909 rounds per minute. That's insane. That's impressive. But if you want to bump it up, throw rapid fire and extended mags on it. Then it's at 967 rounds per minute with a massive 56-round magazine and a relatively quick 2.1-second reload time. The VMP did get nerfed after a while, so its range wasn't quite too ridiculous, but it is still one of the best SMGs in the game, and it is a perfect way to start our list today. At number 9, and this is a lesser remembered SMG, and I don't really understand. Well, I do understand. I'll explain why. The PP90M1 in Modern Warfare 3. The reason it is lesser remembered is because it was overshadowed by the MP7. The PP90 was a total bullet hose that fired at 1,016 rounds per minute while dealing a maximum of 42 damage per bullet, making it one of the hardest hitting guns on this list in terms of individual bullet damage. Here's the downside of the gun though. It had a paltry 36 round mag that you would burn through in a matter of seconds, but the sheer melting power of this gun, and it looked really cool. I mean, it really did, especially if you were running sleight of hand so you wouldn't have to worry about the slow reload time. Definitely worthy of being in the top 10 SMGs if you ask me. Once again, this one's kind of the unsung hero. It goes unnoticed a lot. This month's giveaway is for a new PlayStation 4 console. All you have to do to enter is drop a like on this video, be subscribed to the channel, and turn on your notifications so you never miss an upload. And in the comment section, let me know why you want to win the PS4 and include your Twitter handle so I can contact you if you're the winner. The winner will be announced at the end of the month. At number 8, arguably the smoothest SMG in COD history, the MSMC in Black Ops 2. The MLG submachine gun of choice back in the BO2 days, everybody was running it. The MSMC was hands down one of the most versatile guns in BO2, and it was one of the most used guns in multiplayer because of that very reason. The MSMC had a moderate fire rate and pretty low recoil, and it hit like a truck. It dealt a maximum of 40 damage up close. Now, it did have a pretty long reload animation compared to other SMGs in the game, but it was well worth it. The trade-off was there. You could put a 40-round mag on this thing with the extended round, with the extended mag attachment as well, or you could just throw in some fast mags and not have to worry about the long reload. This thing was an absolute laser. While it may not have spit bullets as quickly as some of the other guns on this list, its high damage and reliability is what made it so melty and definitely worthy of a spot. Some would probably argue that it could be higher. At number 7, we have the AK-74U in the original Black Ops. Hands down, the most popular SMG in the game, it was one of the most satisfying guns to use thanks to its firing sound and its sheer stopping power, especially on smaller maps like Nuketown in firing range. The 74U was unlocked pretty quickly at level 17, and it's ridiculously strong. And if I'm being honest, it's really easy to use due to its low recoil. This baby hit for 35 damage for up to 22 meters, making it a 3-shot kill anywhere on the body. And while it does drop down to 20 damage at range, it would still have a 1.4 times multiplier to the head, which makes it very easy to kill people past 22 meters as long as you could hit them in the head twice. Now, it only fired 750 rounds per minute, but its sheer damage makes it deserving of a spot on the list today, because even though it didn't fire as quickly as these other guns, it still killed extremely quickly due to its high damage. And it got a nerf. It got a hard nerf. So some of you may not remember this thing in its prime, but when Black Ops launched, this gun was beyond overpowered. At number 6, and this one's going to surprise some people because this thing never gets any love, the AK-74U in COD 4. the original COD appearance of this gun. It first appeared in COD 4. It was considered by many to be the strongest SMG in the game, like in Black Ops. The COD 4 version, it fired relatively slow, but it hit insanely hard, even harder than the Black Ops version. The COD 4 AK-74U fired at 800 rounds per minute and dealt up to 40 damage, and that was not even using stopping power. It actually featured the same damage stats as the MP5, but I'm going to give the AK the spot on the list because it had less recoil. It made it easier to control and leading to people melting enemies much more efficiently, and I promise you, nobody even thinks about this SMG anymore. Cracking into the top 5, the scariest sounding SMG, the PPSH in World at War. You guys knew the gun was going to be on here, you just didn't know where I was going to put it. This thing is the definition of a bullet hose. This weapon fired at a whopping 1,250 rounds per minute, people, but would only hit for a maximum of 22 damage per bullet. This made it extremely ineffective at range, but up close, you would delete people almost immediately, despite the fact that it would take 5 bullets to kill without stopping power. Plus, with the round drum attachment, you could hold up to 70 bullets at a time, which would give you the ability to just hold down the trigger and spray away. I mean, this gun, not only in terms of sound, but in terms of just sheer bullets going down range, was super, super intimidating. And I'm talking about the old school original World at War, not the new stuff. At number 4, we have the Spitfire in Black Ops 4. This is the fastest killing SMG in the game. The weapon has probably been pissing off a lot of people due to how fast it melts people, despite how much the time to kill has been increased in Black Ops 4. The Spitfire will deal a maximum of 27 damage at close range, and it requires 6 to 9 shots to kill, which is a lot compared to others, but what makes it so melty is the insane fire rate at 1,060 rounds per minute, making it the fastest firing gun in Black Ops 4. Now, in a game like this where gunfights are longer and health is increased, a gun that still manages to kill this quickly is going to be used by a ton of players, and that's probably why you've seen it all over the place in multiplayer. At number 3, and I still have no idea how this thing got through testing without anybody at Infinity Ward saying anything, the MP7 in Modern Warfare 3. Hands down, the best gun in the game, and it's still overpowered to this day. Go try it out. This SMG had a 40-round mag by default, and it would deal up to 35 damage per bullet with a fire rate of 895 rounds per minute. Plus, this thing had hardly any recoil and some very, very generous range, making it essentially a pocket assault rifle. Plus, on top of the plus, you could throw on extended mags to make it 60 rounds, and then the rapid fire attachment would make it up to almost 1,200 rounds per minute, making it hands down one of the fastest killing guns in the game. The only downsides to the gun were the long reload time at 3 seconds and the fact you could burn through your ammo super quickly. But if you ran the right perks, you didn't have to worry about either of those. It's hand down one of the most popular guns in the game, and for good reason. At number 2, we're going with the Scorpion Evo in Black Ops 2. Another bullet hose. You loved having it, but you hated going up against it. This baby did pretty low damage, as it would only do 33 at point blank range, and then it would drop down all the way to 18. But its fire rate is why it's king. The Scorpion Evo is one of the fastest firing guns in COD history at 1,250 rounds per minute, making it theoretically capable of dealing close to 700 damage per second. You heard me right. The Black Ops 2 Scorpion was capable of 700 damage per second. It had a small mag, all things considered. You could burn through it almost immediately, but the fact that you could take multiple people down in less than a second is what made it so powerful and so tough to counter, because, I mean, what are you supposed to do against this? And at number 1 today, and this is probably going to start a war in the comments because you probably didn't see this coming, but remember, this is my personal list, okay? The Vesper in Black Ops 3. We're going to look at raw numbers. With raw numbers, it's actually the fastest killing SMG in COD history, even faster than the Scorpion. Now, this thing has had quite a strange time in Black Ops 3 due to how much it was buffed and nerfed and then buffed again. But throughout the entire lifespan of the game, the Vesper remained a high-tier SMG, and during its prime, it was easily one of the fastest killing guns in the game. This bullpup submachine gun dealt a maximum of 33 damage and fired at 1,250 rounds per minute, the same as the Scorpion, okay? But what makes the Vesper even more powerful was the range. Now, the Scorpion's damage would drop off to 18 at range, but the Vesper would only drop down to 20, making it even more threatening at longer ranges than the Scorpion, and a little more accurate. So the Vesper may not be as much of a fan favorite as the Scorpion was. It's statistically more powerful, and that is why I gave it the number 1 spot on today's list. And there you go, guys. That is my list for the fastest killing SMGs in COD history. You let me know where I got it right. You let me know where I got it wrong. Let me know what your number 1 gun is. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, drop a like. Make sure you're subscribed. Turn on those notifications so you never miss an upload on the channel. And I'll see you guys soon.